Hello everyone, and welcome to Ben Plays Games. Today, I want to talk about weight, and I want to talk about movement. Not the weight I've put on while stuck working at home due to a lack of movement, no, but rather how movement and the feeling of weight work in tandem in Dead Space, and why that makes it feel a cut above many other similar titles. If you enjoy it, please do be sure to hit subscribe, and now, let's spacewalk over to the USG Ishimura. There's very few who would argue that Isaac Clarke had it easy during his first trip to the USG Ishimura. Clarke travelled to the Planet Cracker as part of a team of five in the year 2508, tasked with performing maintenance on the ship and investigating a communications blackout that had left it completely dark. As an added incentive, Isaac's girlfriend, Nicole Brennan, also worked on the Ishimura, and her safety, at least in his eyes, is objective number one. But unfortunately for Isaac and the team, it's not long before things take a turn for the worse. On arrival, the ship is seemingly devoid of life, calm and quiet, but it's not long before a welcome party turns up, two of the crew are killed, and Isaac finds himself in a party of three. And to make matters worse, he's separated from the rest of his squad as well. So begins Dead Space, the tale of a lone engineer clunking his way through the Ishimura in his Resource Integration Unit, or RIG for short, desperately trying to find his girlfriend in terrifying new surroundings. And it's the idea behind this clunking, the feeling of weight in the way Isaac moves and interacts with his environment, that I want to take a closer look at today. Have you ever played a game where it just doesn't feel quite like your character is attached to the game's backdrop? One where controlling them doesn't evoke a feeling of movement through an environment, but rather a feeling of detachment from the bigger picture? Like they are two separate entities sitting one on top of the other, never truly connected. It's something you may not have even noticed before, and even when you did, it may not have actually detracted from your experience too much. After all, most games have quite a bit more to focus on than just that. But get that feeling of attachment to the environment right, and the most basic of gameplay elements, simply moving your character through an environment, is taken to a whole new level. And Dead Space, ladies and gents, is a game which gets this absolutely spot on. I'm guessing some of you who watch this might wonder whether, if at best I'm making a leap, or at worst, whether I'm completely off my rocker talking about this. But I implore you, if you haven't already, to spend just 5 minutes moving Isaac through the narrow corridors of the Ishimura to get a feel for how he moves. An engineer wearing a heavy engineering suit, Isaac's movement could never be described as particularly fleet-footed, but what it does feel like, in every action you instruct Isaac to take, and in the animations he uses to perform those actions, is heavy. When you run down a hallway, turn a corridor, or raise your gun, Isaac is imbued with a sense of weight. This extends to the punches and stamps in his arsenal as well, which feel kinetically almost akin to trying to perform the action underwater. In what may come as a frustration to some, you're not even able to quick turn, making assaults from the rear become a far more dangerous prospect than they'd otherwise be. The movement may be slower than you're used to, bordering on lumbering at times, but the player is afforded such tight control of the character that it quickly becomes a strength for the game as a whole. You are completely attached to the area you're in, with your rig ultimately acting as a tether between the man and the environment. Sure, you're not bounding through the environment like Lara Croft, climbing ledges with ease and chucking in a handstand for good measure, but it fits perfectly against a backdrop almost overwhelmingly industrial, filled with huge pieces of machinery and predominantly tight spaces. Spaces, I'd hazard a guess, which were designed in part to further the horror, but also in part to mesh optimally with Isaac's movement. A Tomb Raider game set mainly in small indoor areas just wouldn't make sense given the way Lara moves, much like a Dead Space game set in uneven outdoor environments wouldn't make sense either. The former's environments give you great freedom of movement as you skip nimbly between opponents, whether that be beasts with claws or men with guns, while the latter understands your movement is slower, perhaps somewhat less precise, and so sticks predominantly to enemies with melee-based attacks. Although, my goodness, there's certainly moments in Dead Space 3, for some reason, that go in the other direction. But the less said about those parts, the better, I think. When the necromorphs begin to appear en masse not long after the game's opening, and the game quickly becomes more violent, it's immediately obvious that the feeling everything has a weight to it, and moves and reacts as such, extends to the gunplay, and to your necromorph foes as well. Combat is less about simply pointing and shooting at enemies one by one until an arena is cleared, and more about prioritising which target out of the many in close vicinity you aim for first, so that you can buy enough time to create space between yourself and the other three monstrosities approaching from behind. In this sense, the idea of weight and movement is more abstract, the horde combining to become a tidal wave, which at times it's more beneficial to simply push back to create more space for yourself rather than vanquish entirely. But it is more tangible than that too, and much of that comes from the dismemberment system the game has become famous for. Rather than aim for the head of an enemy, in Dead Space it's far more beneficial to aim for the limbs, and it's something you'll spend a lot of time doing. The weapons on offer, the majority of which are engineering tools, a brilliant combination of setting and circumstance, feel like they have real weight behind them. And a lot of that weight comes from the necromorph's reactions when your shots connect, finishing blows often quite literally pushing your vanquished assailants backwards and into the air. No weapon demonstrates this better than the force gun, which, when used at close range, will propel enemies halfway across the room, such as the sheer power behind every shot. Add to that stasis, your ability to slow enemies to a crawl, buying time for you to pick off limbs, or to deliver a few extra blows, an option which also effectively allows you to manage enemy movement as well as your own, and kinesis, which lets you take advantage of inanimate objects' weight by sending them barreling in the direction of necromorphs, and you're left with a game where the combat is so visceral, with so much emphasis placed on movement and weight, it's about as close as you can get to truly feeling what the character behind the screen, in this case Isaac Clarke, is going through. It's a constant tug of war between managing Isaac's movement to escape the enemies you're facing, while also using your own weight, in the form of the weapons you carry, to push back when an opening presents itself, all the while also managing enemy movements with stasis. It's truly fantastic stuff. And before I move on, I know this isn't strictly Dead Space related, but if you want to experience what I consider to be the crowning achievement in making gunplay feel like there's real weight to it, try and hunt down a copy of Killzone 2. It's a middling to decent first-person shooter, but it has the best gun feedback system I've ever encountered, and I don't think it's been beaten yet. The final piece of this puzzle comes in the form of sound design, and while there's not a million things to say about it, it does exactly the job it needs to. Isaac's footsteps sound heavy, which in turn makes them feel even heavier than they already did. Punches and stamps make the appropriate thuds, and your weapons not only sound like they hit hard, but like they fire hard too. It's perhaps the least important part of the three strands I've spoken about during this video, but if it didn't work as well as it did, a lot would have been lost. And last but not least, a quick shout out to the zero gravity areas as well. While you may ask how they're connected to this at all, I think they provide a fantastic juxtaposition where you go from feeling incredibly heavy and lumbering to completely weightless, and it makes you feel heavier when you move back inside. You never get to experience what's in between the two extremes, but in this game, I don't think you need to. Isaac's movement and the weight behind everything he does, the gunplay's kineticism and the excellent sound design combine to create a symphony unlike much else in the genre. It's a game clearly influenced by the extraordinary success of Resident Evil 4's action focus, but one that took that success and instead of simply imitating it with a next-gen sheen, instead iterated on the formula and took it a step further. In short, Dead Space was one small step for man, but one giant leap for the horror shooter. Thank you everyone for taking the time to watch the video, I really, really appreciate it. If you did enjoy it, I'd be over the moon if you'd hit the subscribe button, and hopefully, I'll see you all soon.